Hi! Surprise! I'm back. I wanted to make a video talking about, like, what happened and what did I do while I was gone. A lot of people want to know, like, why didn't you keep doing YouTube and stuff? There's a lot more things I want to do than YouTube, and YouTube was taking up a lot of time to do those other things. So, I obviously was doing acting for a long time, and when I left YouTube I was still pursuing acting. I just got my degree in screenwriting, so right now I'm working on that. I'm writing scripts, have some like book ideas. I write poetry, like everything that I can write, I do it. I don't really want to talk about why I left, just because it's gonna deter this whole thing. Basically, YouTube was taking up too much of my time. Contracts that I were bound to were way too restrictive for me. That's all I'm gonna say, because it's not really important, because that's the past, and that was a very long time ago. I stopped doing the show when I was like 13 or 14, and I'm 22 now, so I don't really feel the need to keep explaining myself to people. So I'm not going to be answering questions about why did I leave or anything like that. If you want to ask about the experience, maybe I'll answer. I mean, it depends on the question. I want to talk about why I'm making this video, why I came back. The simple answer is because I want to help people. I've been going through something for about, well, over a year now. It started last year in March. I started feeling not like myself physically. I've always had anxiety and depression, so I know how to deal with that. I know what that feels like. This was something completely different. Basically, I was in pain every day. Everything I ate made me feel sick. I couldn't sleep because the pain was so bad. I would have chest pains, throat pain, stomach pain, just all the time, and I couldn't figure out what it was, and it didn't really matter what I ate. Everything I ate didn't make me feel good, so I literally could not eat because I felt so sick. I would just drink smoothies all the time, and I'm like, this isn't normal. This is while I was still in college trying to get my degree in screenwriting, and it really took a toll on me because I still had to keep up with classes. And I don't know if any of you have been to film school, like real film school. There's no breaks. You have 3-hour classes each. Sometimes they're back to back, sometimes you have 3 in a row, and your breaks are on the weekend, and that's it. You don't have a summer break, you don't have a spring break. The only break you get is Christmas, and that's like 2 weeks out of the whole year. It's year-round school. So I didn't really have time to be feeling like this, so I was like, let's get on top of this. What is this? How do I deal with it? Because I don't feel good. I'm in pain. I can barely get through my classes. I can barely get through all my work. And I can't eat. I'm losing weight like crazy. So I go to the doctor, and the doctor doesn't believe me. She tells me, oh, you're just anxious. And I kind of had to just take that and go, because there was nothing else she was going to offer me. All of my pain and everything continued, so I'm like, okay, this is not in my head. I'm not making this up. I've never felt this before, so something is wrong. And I actually requested to see a different doctor, who ended up being one of my friend's moms, and she within 10 minutes said, oh, that sounds like GERD. And I was like, I don't know what that is. I've never heard of that. In a very short term, it's acid reflux, but it affects everything. It even makes my ears hurt. Like, it affects everything, your whole digestive system. Because your acid is coming up into your throat and it burns, and I would get these severe chest pains that felt like I was being stabbed. People that don't know that they have GERD, when they get those chest pains, sometimes they drive to the hospital because they think it's a heart attack. Like, it's severe. When she told me that, I just felt like a huge relief, because I'm like, okay, I'm not making this up. This is real and it's happening. And yeah, it sucks, but like, at least now I know that I have this thing, now we can treat it, right? Well, I mean, here I am still suffering, so it's not really, my journey has not been like this. It's been like this, and I'm really tired of it, but the thing is that I'm still going. I've done a lot of tests, and I want to talk about it in other videos. When I was going through that, it was so scary. It was so terrifying. I don't know anyone that has anything like this, especially not my age. Are you kidding me? Everyone my age is like going out partying till like 5 a.m. whatever, like, and they're fine. Me, I eat one little like thing that's wrong and my whole body freaks out. I felt alone. I felt like I was losing my life, like the life that I had. Like, I couldn't keep up anymore. One minute I could be fine, the next minute I'm in severe pain, and like I can't just leave in the middle of class because I don't feel good. I'm still learning how to manage it. Obviously, it's a thing that I'm always going to keep learning about, and it's not 100% that I have this, because it's not like you can do a blood test and just say, oh yeah, it's this. Some of the specialists that I've seen also think I might have IBS. So just, if anyone out there has IBS watching this video, you know how painful that is and how annoying it is, and just draining, completely draining. It's a lot to deal with, and you have to watch what you eat 100% of the time. You can't just have, it's not like a diet, you can't have a cheat day where you have your little pizza and your chocolate. Like, you do that and you might be in bed for a week. So that's why I wanted to make this video, because I don't want anyone else going through what I have or their own, you know, chronic illness to feel alone and to feel lost and to feel like, am I the only one in the world that has this? Because you're not. I've now met people that have similar things to me. I found a lot of help in meeting those people and just going, okay, I'm not the only one that deals with this and that lives with this. A lot of the time I ask myself, why did this happen to me? Why is it not going away? Like, you just expect, you know, it's like if you get a really bad cold, like, yeah, the cough might linger for like a month or so, and then eventually it's gonna go away, right? Well, not this. That's why it's called a chronic illness. So that's what I've been dealing with, and I want to know, like, are there other people out there like me, and where are they, and do they need help? Can we form a community for this? And if we can, then I want to do that, because it's something that we need. Like, no one talks about this. I don't know anyone that talks about chronic illness or invisible illness or disabilities unless they have it themselves, which means I don't know enough people either that have it, or I don't know enough people that are comfortable telling me that they have it or telling anyone that they have it. And that's a problem. This is not who I am. I am not a sick person, you know? I have other things about me other than illnesses. I like to write, I like to create, I love animals. There are a lot of other things that define me, and this doesn't define me, but I still have to live with it, and I still have to figure out, you know, how to manage the pain, how to manage what I'm gonna eat. Everything, it affects everything. And so I want to make these videos to put out there in the world that this is a thing and it's happening, and maybe your friend has something and they're not telling you because they think you're gonna judge them and they think that you're not gonna believe them, or maybe you have something and you're scared to talk about it because whenever you do, people just say, oh, that sucks, and then they don't care, they don't remember that, you know, you can't do certain things. There are certain things you're limited, and that's okay. And if you want this to be the place where you can talk about it, I'm gonna let you guys do that. If you want to comment, you know, your experience, or if you have questions, maybe you want to know how I deal with things, what I do, or maybe you know someone who has something and you don't know how to talk about it with them, or if they want to talk about it, you don't know how to bring it up, you guys are more than welcome to ask me. The only questions I'm not gonna allow are gonna be, do you exercise and how much water do you drink? Because trust me, I've tried everything in the book, so no unsolicited advice, please. I just want to open this up for anyone that is trying to learn more about these topics, Or if you just want to ask a question about me, like about my writing or something, that's fine too. I wanted to use my voice to put it to this subject because I think it's super important. So if you guys want to ask me anything in the comments, please feel free to. If this isn't your thing, you can ask me something else or just leave it at that. That's totally fine. I'm planning on doing some videos talking more in depth about this. Thank you guys for watching this video, and thank you in advance for any comments that you guys leave. I really appreciate it, and I hope that everyone is feeling well and taking care of themselves during this time. See you guys next time.